Well, thank you for joining us for this combined Addison Street Community Church Christian Fellowship Free Church Good Friday Tenebrae service. We really should have come up with a little bit catchier name for this. The word Tenebrae is Latin for darkness. This is a service that reminds us of the darkness that fell on earth when Jesus died on the cross for our sins. It's a pretty simple service, focusing around the readings from the Gospel of Mark, looking at the final days of the life of Jesus. Throughout the night, as we do these different readings, the candles before me will be snuffed out until we are left in darkness, not unlike the darkness the disciples found themselves in on that Good Friday. Throughout the service, after each reading, there will be a call and response that we hope that you'll participate in with us. The call will come from Romans 5:8, but God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. The response, thanks be to God. So let's try that once, everybody together. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
Thanks be to God.
Good job, guys. As I said, we're going to close the service in darkness. Traditionally, at the conclusion of a Tenebrae service, people would leave in silence. And for generations, as this service has been practiced, they would hold silence even all the way till Sunday morning. Now, I don't expect you to hold silence all the way till Sunday, but I would encourage you not to rush into some other activity, but rather let that silence draw you into the presence of God. Let it draw you in to the sacrifice that Christ made for us. At this time of year, we have to take responsibility and be reminded of the sin that we have committed that helped put Jesus on that cross. And so today, after we hear the reading from accounting of Peter's denial, we'll have some time where you can silently to yourself and to God reflect and confess the sins that you have committed. We hope that this service is a time where you are able to be in and dwell in not only the sacrifice that Christ made, but the grief that comes along with that. It's okay to be sad. It's okay to grieve. It's okay to be sorry about that, because we know that Sunday comes. Sunday is coming and the tomb is empty. And so we would like to invite you this Sunday to partake in one of the Easter celebrations that either of our churches will be holding online. Let's pray and then we can begin. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather, even virtually online, to reflect on, to celebrate, to even mourn the death of Jesus on the cross. Lord, as we walk through these final days of the life of Jesus, help us to engage with our minds, with our souls, with all that we are, even our emotions, as we reflect on the sacrifice that was made on our behalf through Jesus. Lord, we thank you and praise you for sending your Son to die on the cross for our sins. Amen. Please join us as we worship the Lord.
There's a place where mercy reigns and never dies. There's a place where streams of grace flow deep and wide, where all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross, I surrender my life. I'm in awe of you, I'm in awe of you. Where your love ran red and my sin washed white, I owe all to you, I owe all to you. There's a place where sin and shame
Mark 14:1-11. Now the Passover and unleavened bread were 2 days away, and the chief priests and the scribes were seeking how to seize him by stealth and kill him, for they were saying, "Not during the festival, otherwise there might be a riot of the people." While he was in Bethany at the home of Simon the leper, and reclining at the table, there came a woman with an alabaster vial of very costly perfume of pure nard, and she broke the vial and poured it over his head. But some were indignantly remarking to one another, "Why has this perfume been wasted?" For this perfume might have been sold for over 300 denarii, and the money given to the poor. And they were scolding her. But Jesus said, "Let her alone. Why do you bother her? She has done a good deed to me. For you always have the poor with you, and whenever you wish, you can do good to them. But you do not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body beforehand for the burial. Truly I say to you, wherever the gospel is preached in the whole world, what this woman has done will also be spoken of in memory of her." Then Judas Iscariot, who was one of the 12, went off to the chief priests in order to betray him to them. They were glad when they heard this, and promised to give him money. And he began seeking how to betray him at an opportune time.
But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Thanks be to God.
He will embrace me in his
And on the first day of unleavened bread, when they sacrificed the Passover lamb, his disciples said to him, "Where will you have us go and prepare for you to eat the Passover?" And he sent two of his disciples and said to them, "Go into the city, and a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him, and wherever he enters, say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says, where is my guest room, where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room furnished and ready. There prepare for us." And the disciples set out and went to the city and found it just as he had told them. And they prepared the Passover. And when it was evening, he came with the 12. And as they were reclining at table and eating, Jesus said, "Truly I say to you, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me." They began to be sorrowful and to say to him and to one another, "Is it I?" He said to them, "It is one of the 12, one who is dipping bread into the dish with me. For the Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had not been born." And as they were eating, he took bread, and after blessing it, he broke it and gave it to them and said, "Take, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I say to you, I will not drink again of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink of it in the new kingdom of God." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives.
God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Thanks be to God.
Sin placed on him, the hope of every man. Oh, the blood of Jesus washes me. Oh, the blood of Jesus shed for me. What a sad bless the blood, it is my victory. Savior, Son, Holy One, slain so I can live. See the Lamb, the great I am, who takes away my sin. Oh, the blood of Jesus washes me. Oh, the blood of Jesus shed for me. What a sacrifice that saved my life. Yes, the blood, it is my victory.
Jesus said to them, "You will fall away, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Even though they all fall away, I will not." And Jesus said to him, "Truly, I tell you, this very night, before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me three times." But he said emphatically, "If I must die with you, I will not deny you." And they all said the same. And they went to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." And he took with him Peter and James and John, and he began to be greatly distressed and troubled. And he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch." Going a little farther, he fell on the ground and prayed that if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. And he said, "Abba, Father, all things are possible for you. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I will, but what you will." And he came and he found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, Simon, are you asleep? Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed, saying the same words. And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy. They did not know what to answer him. And he came the third time and said to them, are you still sleeping and taking your rest? It is enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise. Let us be going. See? My betrayer is at hand. And immediately while he was still speaking, Judas came, one of the 12, and with a crowd, with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the scribes and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, the one I will kiss is the man. Seize him and lead him away under guard. And when he came, he went up to him at once and said, Rabbi. And he kissed him. And they laid hands on him and seized him. But one of those who stood by drew his sword and struck the servant of the high priest and cut off his ear. And Jesus said to them, have you come out as against a robber with swords and clubs to capture me? Day after day I was with you in the temple teaching, and you did not seize me. But let the scriptures be fulfilled. And they all left him and fled. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
Going up to the mountain of mercy, to the crimson perpetual tide. Kneel down on the shore, be thirsty no more. Go under and be purified. Follow Christ to the holy mountain. Sinner sorry and wrecked by the fall. Cleanse your heart and your soul in the fountain that flows. For you and for me and for all. At the wonderful, tragic, mysterious truth, on that beautiful, scandalous night, you and me, we're atoned by his blood, forever washed white. That beautiful, scandalous night. You will be delivered at the foot of the cross, justified, and your spirit restored by the river that pours from our blessed Savior's side. At the wonderful, tragic, mysterious street, on that beautiful, scandalous night, you and me, we're atoned by his blood, forever washed white, on that beautiful, scandalous night. At the wonderful, tragic, mysterious street, on that beautiful, scandalous night, you and me, we're atoned by his blood, forever washed white, on that beautiful, scandalous night. That beautiful, scandalous
I'm reading to you today from the book of Mark, chapter 14, verses 53 through 65. I'm reading in the English Standard Version, starting in verse 53. And they led Jesus to the high priest, and all the chief priests and the elders and the scribes came together. And Peter had followed him at a distance, right into the courtyard of the high priest. And he was sitting with the guards and warming himself at the fire. Now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking testimony against Jesus to put him to death, but they found none, for many bore false witness against him. But their testimony did not agree, and some stood up and bore false witness against him, saying, "We heard him say, 'I will destroy this temple that is made with hands, and in 3 days I will build another, not made with hands.' Yet even about this, their testimony did not agree. And the high priest stood up in the midst and asked Jesus, 'Have you no answer to make? What is it that these men testify against you?' But he remained silent and made no answer. Again, the high priest asked him, 'Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed?' And Jesus said, 'I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming with the clouds of heaven.' And the high priest tore his garments and said, 'What further witness do we need? You have heard this blasphemy. What is your decision?' And they all condemned him as deserving death. And some began to spit on him and to cover his face and to strike him, saying to him, 'Prophesy.' And the guards received him with blows." This is the word of the Lord.
The guards received him with blows. But God demonstrates his love, own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Thanks be to God.
It is paid in full by
As Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came, and seeing Peter warming himself, she looked at him and said, "You also were with that Nazarene Jesus." But he denied it, saying, "I neither know nor understand what you mean." And he went out into the gateway, and the rooster crowed. And the servant girl saw him and began again to say to the bystanders, "This man is one of them." But again he denied it. And after a while, the bystanders again said to Peter, "Certainly you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." But he began to invoke a curse on himself and to swear, "I do not know this man of whom you speak." And immediately the rooster crowed a second time. And Peter remembered how Jesus had said to him, "Before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me three times." And he broke down and wept. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
And as soon as it was morning, the chief priests held a consultation with the elders and scribes and the whole council. And they bound Jesus and led him away and delivered him over to Pilate. And Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" And he answered him, "You have said so." And the chief priests accused him of many things. And Pilate again asked him, "Have you no answer to make? See how many charges they bring against you?" But Jesus made no further answer, so that Pilate was amazed. Now at the feast, he used to release for them one prisoner for whom they asked. And among the rebels in prison who had committed murder in the insurrection, there was a man named called Barabbas. And the crowd came up and began to ask Pilate to do as he usually did for them. And he answered them, saying, "Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?" For he perceived that it was out of envy that the chief priests had delivered him up. But the chief priests stirred up the crowd to have them release for them Barabbas instead. Pilate again said to them, "Then what shall I do with the man you call the King of the Jews?" And they cried out again, "Crucify him." Pilate said to them, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Crucify him!" So Pilate, wishing to satisfy the crowd, released for them Barabbas. And having scourged Jesus, he delivered him to be crucified. And the soldiers led him away inside the palace, that is the governor's headquarters, and they called together the whole battalion. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on him, and they began to salute him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they were striking his head with a reed and spitting on him and kneeling down in homage to him. When they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. And they led him out to crucify him. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
Stricken, smitten, and afflicted, see him dying on the tree. 'Tis the Christ by men rejected, yes, my soul, 'tis he, 'tis he. 'Tis the long-expected prophet, David's son, yet David's Lord. By his Son God now has spoken, 'tis the true and faithful word. Tell me, ye who hear him groaning, was there ever grief like his? Friends through fear his cause disowning, foes insulting his distress. Many hands were raised to wound him, none would interpose to save. But the deepest stroke that pierced him was the stroke that justice gave. Ye who think of sin but lightly, nor suppose the evil great, here makes you its nature rightly, here its guilt may estimate. Mark the sacrifice appointed, see who bears the awful load. 'Tis the Word, the Lord's anointed, Son of Man and Son of God. Here we have a firm foundation, here the refuge of the lost. Christ, the rock of our salvation, is the name of which we boast. Lamb of God for sinners wounded, sacrifice to cancel guilt. None shall ever be confounded who on him their hope is built.
And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. And they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means place of a skull. And they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him, divided his garments among them, casting lots for them to decide what each should take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him. And the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with him they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "Aha! You who would destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." So also the chief priests with the scribes mocked him to one another, saying, "He saved others. He cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down now from the cross that we may see and believe." Those who were crucified with him also reviled him. When the sixth hour had come, there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour. And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Some of the bystanders hearing it said, "Behold, he's calling for Elijah." And someone ran and filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to take him down." And Jesus uttered a loud cry and breathed his last. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us.
See the destined day arise, see a willing sacrifice, Jesus to redeem our loss, hangs upon the shameful cross. Jesus who but you could bear, wrath so great and justice fair, every pain and bitter foe, finishing your life of woe. Alleluia, alleluia, Lamb of God for sinners slain. Alleluia, alleluia, Jesus Christ, we praise your name. Thank you. who but Christ had dared to drain, steeped in gall the cup of pain, and with tender body bare thorns and nails and piercing spear, slain for us the water flowed. Mingled from your side with blood seemed to all a testimonies of the finished sacrifice. Grace in that sacrifice to place all our trust for life renewed, pardon sin and promise good. Grant us grace to sing your praise round your throne through endless days, ever with the
Father, on that Friday, it looked like all hope was lost. But we know that in actuality, all hope was found at the cross. Lord, we thank you for the life that was bought for us through the death of Jesus. And we thank you for the empty tomb and the power and authority that was declared there. As we wait for that Sunday, and we wait for the coming and the return of Christ, help us to wait well. Amen. Go in peace. We'll connect with you Sunday morning.